Good evening and welcome to the OLSH College Concert 2021 Night 2.
I would now like to begin tonight by acknowledging traditional lands of the Arunda people on which we meet today. We would like to acknowledge the past, present and future custodians of the land.
Just a reminder for this evening that the toilets are on the far left-hand side of the Marion Centre foyer and our exits are all along the left and right-hand side of the Marion Centre underneath the green lights. And another friendly reminder to please turn all mobile phones off. Thank you.
We would now like to hand you over to Megan and Matthew, who will be your MCs for tonight. Thank you.
Oh, sweet Juliet, thy hath such... What are you doing?
I'm Batman.
I see that. Why?
Because I thought we were doing superhero theme this year.
Did you, not read the script?
Of course I read the script.
Oh, really? Script! Right here. Look.
It says Matthew and Megan can't agree to be fired immediately.
Oops.
What was that for? Oh, darn it, now that we don't have a script.
Well, of course, we're just going to have to introduce ourselves.
So what do we
do? Hi, everyone. I am Megan.
And I'm Matt.
And we would like to be your totally not fired hosts for this college concert of 2021, second night.
Sorry. Great. So what do we do now?
Introduce the first act. Duh.
How do we find out what the first act is if we don't have a script?
You mean that one?
Found it!
Yeah? Who is it?
We got the Year 7's Got Talent first up. Can we please welcome them to the stage?
Thank you.
There we go. Wow, wasn't that great?
Yeah, that wasn't great.
Yeah, let's hear it up for the year sevens again. Come on.
It's really, honestly, great to know that there's still talent in these generations. They're so much better than a certain someone I know.
Yeah, I'll say. Last time I was at a talent show, I saw a barber get kicked out. Guess you could say he didn't make the cut.
We would now like to introduce Room 5 with their song and dance.
Give them a huge round of applause.
Thank you.
Okay, maybe we should leave the dancing to the professionals, Megan?
Definitely.
Anyways, can we please welcome our next stop from Room 11 with their performance of Nightlight?
Everyone, let's give them a huge round of applause.
Nightlight, written by Room 11.
Nightlight, some days are dark, some are bright. Don't forget, there's always a light to shine up your night. Having no friends makes me sad. Even the days go bad. With nobody around, it makes me feel down. Don't forget, a true happy place is a place deep inside that bubbles and glistens and glows and turns your frown upside down.
Do you ever feel like a plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again? Do you ever feel this so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you ever feel already buried deep, 6 feet under screens but no one seems to hear a thing? Do you know that there's still a chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just on the night, like the 4th of July. 'Cause baby, you're a firework. Come on, show them what you work. Make them go as you shoot across the sky. After a hurricane comes a rainbow, maybe a reason why all the doors are closed, so you could open one that leads you to the perfect road. Like a lightning bolt, your heart will glow, and when it's time you know, you just gotta ignite the light and live.
You're a firework. Come
Man, wasn't that just great?
Yeah. Oh. With all this talk of nightlights, I sure am sleepy. Surely there's something that can wake me up.
All right, Matthew, one more and you're gonna wish you hadn't.
Oh, come on, lighten up. These puns are great.
No.
Oh, surely they would have brightened someone's day. We would like to now introduce the spectacular Traeger Choir singing their rendition of Wake Me Up.
Inside.
I thought it was Before You Go,
Go. Woo! Let's go, Traeger Choir!
Love.
Wow, wasn't that great?
Yeah, and to think we were both wrong about what the actual song was going to be.
See, this is why it's not good to make such bold assumptions beforehand.
Oh, really? I wasn't the one singing like George Michael over here.
Touché.
Anyway, we would love to now introduce Room 1 with their Australian and animal-themed dance.
It's no Saturday Night Fever, but you can place your bets it's the next best thing.
Matt, of course it's not Saturday night. It's a Friday.
Ah. Jeez. Well, anyways, let's welcome Room 1 to the stage.
Wow, what a performance.
There I am. And from one dance to the next, we'll have Room 16 performing their act, Father's House Dance.
Father's House Dance? What's that about?
Yeah, to be honest, I wouldn't know either, but I'm stoked.
Hi, stoked. I'm Dad.
And you complain about me. Can we please welcome Room 16 to the stage?
Play football, a big house. Oh, it's my father.
Well, that was interesting.
Indeed it was.
All right. For our final act before the interval, we have an exciting performance from Year 5.
I've heard that they are performing a great song from the musical Sister Act.
Sounds very exciting. Can we?
Indeed.
Can we please welcome Year 5 to the stage with their act, Sister Act.
Does it for the first half of our act tonight. What an amazing way to send it off. What can I say? It reminds me of when I was in my prime.
You were good at some point?
Of course I was. I was a natural.
Huh, never guessed.
I'll show you.
While Megan's off doing her thing, we will be having a 20-minute interval. So, in the meantime, help yourself to some food. Go to the bathroom if you need, mingle with your friends. If you're by yourself, mingle with yourself, I guess. do whatever you want to. And just before you go, we've had a reoccurring issue in the past where some parents might have left during intermission, and no judgment whatsoever, but it'd be really nice for those planning to leave early if they could stick on by just to witness some more incredible acts that I'm sure you do not want to miss out. Well, as they say globally, adios, sayonara, au revoir, ciao, goodbye, and we'll see you in 20 minutes.
Cause nothing but trouble. I understand if you can't talk to me again. And if you live by the rules of it's over, then I'm sure that that makes sense. But I will go down with this ship.
Spilling out and staggering in the square. There's lads and lasses falling about and a crackling in the air. Down around the dungeon doors, the shutters and the queues. Everybody's looking for somebody's arms to fall into. That's what it is. That's what it is now. Here's frost.
lost on the graves and the monuments, but the taverns are warm in town. People curse the government and shovel hard food down. Lights are out in City Hall, the castle and the keep. The moon shines down upon it all, the legless and the sleepless. Cold on the toll gate where the wagon's creeping through. Cold on the toll gate, God knows what I can do. Gavison sleeps in the citadel with a ghost and an ancient stone. High on the parapet, a Scottish piper stands alone. And high on the wind, the Highland runs me to the road. Something from the past just comes and stares into my soul. Cold on a toll gate with a Caledonian moon. Cold on a toll gate, God knows what I can do. On Charlotte Street, I take a walking stick from my hotel. The ghost of Dirty Dick is still in search of Little Nell. It's what it is. It's what it is now. It's what it is. What it is now.
Little bit, now you got it. That's it. What are you thinking? Things will go sour. Take its temperature every hour. Nervous when you own it, nervous when it's gone. What do you think has been going on for so long?
Good evening, everyone. If you have students who've already performed tonight and they're in the holding rooms now and you'd like them to come and sit with you, you're absolutely welcome to go and get your kids and bring them back, because we've had a couple of people leave with little tiny ones. So if anyone would like their kids to come and watch and they've already performed in the first act, they are welcome to come and sit with you. If you see one of the students in the orange vests out the front, they will be able to help you and direct you to where your students are.
trying to find my way. We don't live as brothers. There'll be no more fussing and fighting, no more hungry, innocent dying.
Then they are gone. comfort in loneliness, my hope in the dark. All of my life, Lord, please stay with me. Be my sustaining breath, guardian of my heart.
Ladies and gentlemen, please take a seat as we'll be starting in about 3 minutes.
Of an angel, pretty eyes that shine, I lie awake at night wishing you were mine. I'm standing here holding the biggest heartache in town. Whenever you come, I try to speak, but the words won't come.
I'm so scared to death.
When you smile, that's my world turns upside down.
Whenever you come
Well, aloha. Welcome back to this spectacular second half of tonight's show, everybody.
See? I was a star, didn't you know? No one knows talent these days. When did everyone get back?
I don't know. Maybe on time like they were supposed to?
Really? Sounds fake.
Enough with that. Let's just get right to it.
And what a better way to start it off with than Room 15's God's Great Dance.
Let's make them feel welcome.
Start.
Wow, what a great performance.
I'll say, but I'm also really excited for the next one.
I know. Oh, I've always wanted to be a knight, swinging my sword in the midst of battle, fighting off dangerous fiends, getting the girl. Oh, being a knight would be great.
A knight? Why would you be a knight?
Because that's what our next act's called, Dragon Slay.
Actually, I'm pretty sure it's Dragon Slay, you know, like Dragon Slay.
Let's ignore that. Can we please welcome year 11 and 12 Creative Arts to the stage with their act, Dragon Slay.
Just gonna take that slay. I'll do this. I've got to do this. Yeah, I'll go.
No.
I'll just do this.
Smoking and smoldering red. Yes, I wish there really were dragons, great beasts that tower above. For a dragon's whole purpose of being is to be slain in the name of love. But if there aren't any dragons, fearsome foes to all who dare, how then do we show our feelings? How then do we show we care?
Prince Simon has a problem.
A really big problem.
He cannot find a dragon anywhere.
I've searched and searched. I've looked in all the likely places, in the darkest parts of the castle, down back alleyways, even at the local bowling alley.
All the places where a nasty brute like that might hang out. But without success.
I even tried advertising for one. I took out an ad from the chainmail, the local newspaper, in the personal section.
Yes, here it is. Young prince, seeking dragon for purposes of battle? To win the heart of the fair maiden? Was there any responses yet?
Several very strange individuals, but no real dragons.
Ah, speaking of the fair maiden, here comes Princess Ephemeral now.
Hi, Simon. Thanks for the mountain flowers. They're beautiful. Ow,
Major Wince.
Ugh, boys.
It's no use. It's hopeless. I've tried everything, but I can't get her to really, you know, relate to me.
Have you tried speaking to her?
I can't do that.
Oh, and why not?
Well, for one thing, princesses usually travel in packs. They're always whispering and giggling and glancing sideways at the princes. I can't talk to one of them without having the others as an audience, making comments. But I've tried all my best stuff. I've tried doing handstands in front of her, shooting spitballs at her. I've even tried pulling funny faces. But she remains unimpressed.
That is strange.
I know. So I've got to show her I'm really courageous and valiant and brave.
And humble.
Right. I've got to slay a dragon for her.
Dragons are certainly scarce, but I do have it on good authority that there is an old dragon living in the caves, up in the mountains, high up in the North Country.
Good authority, you say?
Well, yes. I heard it from a friend who heard it from their friend, who heard it from their second cousin, who heard it from another man, who also heard it from another man, that there was an old dragon living in the caves, high up on Peril Mountain.
That is good authority. But where will I find this dragon?
Oh, I'll get you a guidebook.
Great, I'll set out immediately.
And Prince Simon did set out immediately, after packing numerous lunches of jam sandwiches and chocolate chip cookies, along with his sword and his shield and several bottles of water, just in case he had to put out some dragon fires. And a spare change of underwear, always important when setting out on a long, perilous journey.
According to Fodder's Guide of the 100 Most Popular Dragons This should be the place. A 4-star rating, fierce, with a classic sense of impending doom. But I don't hear any roars or anything. Maybe they're sleeping. Wait. I think... No, I'm sure. I can smell stale smoke. That's a sure telltale sign of a fierce, fire-breathing dragon. Halt! I am Prince Simon, O fearsome dragon. Prepare to be slain in the name of love.
Yeah, yeah, if it's all the same to you, kid. I'll eat my cereal first. I just poured the milk, I don't want it to get all mushy.
Golden honey bran flakes? What sort of a dragon eats bran flakes?
They're good for you. A good source of dietary fiber.
But you're supposed to breathe fire and roast things alive.
Times change. Everyone's more health conscious these days. I don't breathe a lot of fire anymore. All that barbecued meat is too high in cholesterol. Besides, when you get to be my age, you become more concerned with what comes out the other end. You don't want any fire in the hole, if you know what I mean.
You don't fool me, appearing all harmless. As soon as I lower my guard, you're going to rear back and shoot out a big burst of flames. Aha! You do breathe fire.
Just a smoker's cough, kid. Never smoke. It's a nasty habit. I'm on the patch myself. Trying to quit, but I still got a nasty cough.
Enough of this nonsense. I came to slay a dragon, and that is what I'm going to do. Prepare for battle.
I don't think a dead dragon's going to do it for your princess, kid. Why don't you try some chocolates? Or why don't you try some lollies? Well, why don't you try a nice handcrafted necklace? I know a good gift shop just down the street.
She could get those things from anybody. I have to give her something that no one else can. Something that takes great courage.
The only thing you can give to the princess that no one else can is yourself. And believe me, kid, that takes great courage.
I won't be put off. In the name of Princess Ephemeral and fair maidens everywhere, prepare to do battle.
Fine. Playing rugby.
You used to play rugby?
Fullback. For the Dragons, of course.
This is ridiculous. I can't say a helpless dragon. Where's the honor in that?
Thanks, kid. Help me up. I have an ice pack in the freezer. I haven't hurt this much since I sat on that cactus. You're a lifesaver, kid.
I just hope nobody sees us.
Man, I'm looking at least 6 months of physio.
And I'm looking at a lifetime of loneliness.
After helping the dragon, Prince Simon sadly made his way back to the castle. He knew he had missed his chance to impress Princess Ephemeral. there would not be another dragon to slay. He would have to sit in his tower unnoticed as the princess and her friends floated idly by, alone forever. Or at least, that's what he thought.
Hi, Simon. Aren't they beautiful? I found them out in the meadows.
Yeah, they're lovely, ephemeral. Can I see them? Do you smell that?
I know, it smells like...
stale smoke. Ephemeral?
Yeah?
Would you like to, maybe, after school today, come to my place and play video games? I've got the new Dragon Slay game.
Awesome!
Yes, I wish there really were dragons. Great beasts of ravenous prey. And every creature on earth would scurry and scamper away when the miry, wiry, fiery old dragon raised up their menacing head and breathed out scorching hot flames, smoking and smoldering red. Yes, I wish there really were dragons. Great beasts that thunder and roar. For then, I could prove my worth to you, and who could ask for more? But since there aren't any dragons, no fire, no battle, no fuss, we're left with the much greater challenge of facing each other without armor, just us.
What are you doing?
Isn't this great? We're meditating.
Why?
To introduce the next act, of course. The meditating dance from Bar Street. It was my idea. Isn't it great?
Oh, guys, it's levitating.
Whoa, what is?
Wait.
It's the levitating dance.
Oh, right. Wait.
Levitating? Jeez, Matthew, why didn't you tell us sooner?
Hey, you said it was your idea.
Anyways, we would like to introduce the levitating dance from Bar Street.
Please welcome them to the stage.
It was Meg's idea.
Thank you, Meg.
If you want to run away with me, I know a galaxy and I can take you for a ride. That we fell into a rhythm where the music don't stop for life. Glitter in the sky, glitter in my eyes, shining just the way you like. If you're feeling like you need a little bit of company, you met me at the perfect time. You want me, I want you, baby. My sugar boo, I'm levitating. The Milky Way, we're renegading. Yeah, yeah. Too far. Glitter in the sky, glitter in our eyes, shining just the way we are. I feel like we're forever every time we get together, but whatever, let's get lost on Mars. You want me, I want you, baby. My sugar boo, I'm levitating. The Milky Way, we're renegading. Yeah, 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 yeah. I got you, moonlight. You're my starlight. I need you all night. Come
times when I saw. And even if I wanted to, I can't stop.
Yeah.
My love is like a rocket, watch it blast off. And I'm feeling so electric, dance my ass off. And even if I wanted to, I can't stop. Sugar boo, I'm levitating, the Milky Way, we're renegading. I got you, moonlight, you're my starlight. I need you all night, come on dance with me. I'm levitating.
Matthew, Matthew, Matt. It seems Matthew's taken levitating a bit too seriously tonight. Can anyone see him up there? Hello? Anyway, more time for me. Did you know that in Sydney I came third of three people? Isn't that just amazing? Couldn't you say that I'm the best there's been? I've also heard that this next performer, you could say he's doing just as okay. From what I've seen, he got most promising vocalist 18 years and under at this year's 2021 Centralia Stedford. I mean, it's not national, but I guess it's all right. Anyway, this guy's name is Matthew Minogue, and he will be performing What a Difference a Day Made. Give him a huge round of applause.
Evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'll be your captain for this evening tonight. Sorry, Frankie couldn't make it, but we got the second best thing. What a difference a day made. 24 little hours brought the sun and the flowers where they used to be red. My yesterday was blue, dear. Today I'm a part of you, dear. My lonely nights are through, dear. Since you said you were mine, oh, what a difference a day made. There's a rainbow before me, skies above can be stormy. Since that moment of bliss, that thrilling kiss, it's heaven when you find romance on your menu. What a difference a day made. And the difference is doing tonight. Yeah, that's great. This was originally by Diane Washington, but it's my own interpretation. That right there is 42nd Street. Again, tried to call up Frankie, but he said he had more important things to do. That's okay, more time for me. Nice to see you, Mr. Malloy. My yesterday was blue, dear. Still, I'm a part of you, dear. My lonely nights are through, dear. Since you said you were mine, oh, what a difference a day makes. There's a rainbow before me. Skies above can be stormy. Since that moment of bliss, that thrilling kiss, it's heaven when you find romance on your menu. What a difference a day makes. And the difference is you.
Wait. So, who was gonna tell me that Matthew's last name was my nose and that he could actually sing? What is this? Wait. It's because of me. He took his inspiration from me because we've worked together all night. That's why he performed. It's like master and apprentice, where the master is the good-looking one that still has it, and the apprentice is the one that's doing just as good. He's really getting there. Really, just makes my heart sing, honestly.
Yeah, thanks for waiting for me.
Good job, my pupil.
On what?
Anyway, since when was your last name Moneys? And that's so cool. Too cool.
Yeah, that's right. It's Munoz, and you got it wrong about three other times tonight. So.
Oh, that's just significantly less cool than Moneys.
Thanks, I guess.
We can just fix that in post.
In post?
I hear you asking. Yes, tonight is being recorded. Isn't that exciting? You can relive it every night of your life. You can hear our voices every night of your lives. You can hear his song every night of your life.
You can hear Megan complaining every night of your life.
That's not on tape. Anyway, what else can we do tonight?
Well, now that you mention it, we'd like to welcome to the stage the Year 4 Japanese Ensemble, performing Spring Has Come.
Give them a warm welcome, everyone.
It has come to the village. It has come to the mountains. It has come to the fields.
Tore ganaku, tore ganaku, doko de naku. Yama de naku, sato de naku, do demo naku.
There we go. Wow, what another great performance.
And for our second to last act of the entire 2021 college concert, we have the staff song, which is being performed by Mrs. Summers, Miss Wright, and Brother Tony, who all got together last year and sang Whitney Houston's smash hit, One Moment in Time.
This year, they're trademarking a classic by Andrea Bocelli, entitled, hold on, Conte Partro, or...
which means, time to say goodbye in Italian.
Can we please give them a welcoming round of applause?
Thank you. Quando sono solo, sogno l'orizzonte, manca le parole. Sì, lo so che lo c'è luce, una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu con me
su la finestra mostra tutti il mio cuore che hai acceso, chiudi dentro me la luce che hai incontrato per strada.
Time to say goodbye. Horizons are never far. If I live on this life with pride, holding eternal love in my heart, I will go on ships over seas that I now know they don't exist anymore. It's time to say goodbye.
Quando si lontana sono l'orizzonte mancan le parole. Io sì lo so che si con me tu mia luna, tu sei qui con me. Mio sole, tu sei qui con me, con me, con me, con me.
Time to say goodbye. Horizons are never life with pride, holding eternal love in my heart, I will go on ships overseas that I now know, no, they don't exist anymore. It's time to say goodbye. I will go on ships of the seas that I now know. No, they don't exist anymore. It's time to say goodbye. So with you, I will.
Powerful rendition of such a wonderful song.
Well, folks, sorry to say, but it's about that time. We're near the end, the last hurrah. But the show must go on, for we have one more act to introduce to all you lovely people tonight.
And it wouldn't be OLSH's College Concert without the Year 12s closing the show.
So without further ado,
please welcome
dancing to some old school hits for the very last time,
the class of 2021.
Gonna be this way. Your time's a joke, you broke.
your love lost the whole way. It's like you're always stuck in second gear. But when it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year, well, I'll be there for you. When the rain starts to pour, I'll be there for you. Like I've been there before, I'll be there for you. 'Cause you're there for me too.
Shakira, Shakira.
I never really knew that she could dance like this. She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama? Bonita. Picasa.
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body. I'm on tonight, you know my hips don't lie. And I'm starting to feel it's right. All the attraction, the tension. Don't you see, baby, this is perfection.
Hey, girl, I can see your body moving. And it's driving me crazy. And I didn't have the slightest idea until I saw you dancing. Yeah. And when you walk up on the dance floor, nobody can not ignore the way you move your body, girl. And everything's so unexpected, the way you right and left it. So you can keep on shaking it.
I never really knew that she could dance like this.
She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama? Bonita.
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body.
We'll be right back.
Thank you, Ross. Thank you to the Year 12s. Just a wee comment. I think we're pretty blessed to be in Alice Springs. At the moment, there's a few people in the country locked down, and yet we're so fortunate we can get 1,100 people over two nights to celebrate everything we've seen. And we are lucky. We are so lucky. So thank you to all the performers, all the artists, all the musicians, the dancers, the singers. What a fantastic performance over two nights. Could we please thank them all? Thank you. Thanks, Liam. We've also got so many to thank for the organization for this fantastic concert. We've got Ian Clark and the maintenance crew who set everything up for two nights, cleaned it, washed it down, and got it ready again for tonight. Could we please thank Ian Clark and the maintenance crew? We hope you enjoyed the food as we walked in. Sam Singer set up a fantastic cafe and the food. Could we please thank Sam Singh and all his crew? Thank you, Sam. And also a special thank you to Coca-Cola Armtill, who actually supplied all the water over the two nights. So thank you very much, Jim. Thank you. And it's such organization going over each class, each year group, and over three campuses. And our staff put so much work into it. Could we please thank all the teachers and support staff who put on these performances? A special thank you to Miss Bohe and Miss Nichols, who do so much in the background supporting Jess Wright and her crew. Thank you, Steph, and thank you, Miriam. And to all our brave performers, no more braver than the MCs. Could the four MCs stand up, please? Matt, Wendy, Hamish has gone. Megan, sorry. And Dylan. Thank you, Dylan. Hamish. Thank you to our MCs. Thank you, Hamish. And the people who've done so much organizing for the last 3-4 months and even longer, they've put so much work into it to make sure it works. And there's two special people to thank. Can we thank Ms. Dengra? Could you please come up on stage? And Ms. Summers, please come up stage, Mrs. Summers.
Thanks, Flo. Please.
Thank you, Flo. Stay, please. Mrs. Dengra does so much in the background to make sure it works. And we've had Flo, who has done an amazing job for the last 9 years and was in the background just to make sure it was ticking over. So thank you both, Jasmeet and Fleur. Thank you. Ross Muir, thank you for the sound. It's been outstanding for the last two nights. Thank you very much, Ross. And a big thank you tonight, our concert organizer. She's put in so much work from Traeger, going to each campus and organizing it, and it has taken months. Could we please give a huge hand to Miss Wright?
Thanks, Jess.
Thanks, Jess. That was a great concert. I hope you enjoyed it. Drive safely home, and we look forward to seeing you next year. Thank you. Good night.
We'll do.